Good evening and welcome. I don't think they ran the announcement, but you've been at concerts before, so welcome to the BJ Hahn Auditorium. My voice isn't as deep as the normal voice, but I just would ask you to silence cell phones so to not distract the players during the concert. My name is Eric Hoekstra. It's my joy to welcome you to this Christmastime concert of our instrumental program and to Dordt University. Would you join me in prayer as we begin? Lord our God, it is Advent, a time of waiting and expectation, a tradition in the church that enables us to slow down our lives and remember the really important things, the most important thing, that you are the Christ, Emmanuel, God with us, the Messiah, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And now tonight, Lord, as we worship you with music, we thank you for the performers, the conductors, those who began this university so that those students today could study here, the many, many supporters that have prayed for this place and given of their time and their treasure to make this place possible. We praise you and thank you for calling your church, your people, to do this work at Dordt University. And so tonight, Lord, as we bring you praise, may you receive it as offered, as our love song to you, because of the great love you have for us in Christ Jesus our Lord. And in all things, Lord, may the work of our hands, the music of our hearts, be pleasing and acceptable to you. We thank you for all your good gifts, most of all, our Savior. Amen. Just want to note one thing as we begin. We had something come into our schedules in the last couple of weeks. This morning there was a political event. Randy Feenster, our congressman, asked whether he was able to use it. And last night there were music concerts. Tonight there's music concerts. And I just want to acknowledge, number one, the music department, who was willing to make an adjustment. It was a big deal. And you blessed many people today. But also Missy Bile, Chad Postma, and the sound team who worked to reset up and get all things well. I just want to acknowledge that. It was an institutional priority. You adjusted. And I just want to say thank you to one and all. So God's blessings on this concert, and thank you. Carry on. Good night.
Good evening. I think I probably know most people here, but if you don't know my face, I'm Dr. Ensembles Rose. I'm honored to serve here in our music department as our director of instrumental activities and get the truly awesome opportunity to work with the young lady that you see on the podium in front of our campus band this evening, Dr. Fisher. But the reason I'm up here tonight is Dr. Fisher has asked me to introduce the first of our guest conductors. This man is someone whom I have been good friends with, I would say very close friends with, for a little over 20 years. Met him back in around 2001-2002 timeframe while I was serving with the Marine Band in New Orleans, Louisiana. And since then, we have made much music together. We have spent lots of hours together doing things as close friends. And he has just become one of my closest friends across the world. He reigns from the state of Baden-Württemberg in Germany, and a beautiful little town in southern Germany just south of Stuttgart called Rothenburg am Neckar. Please welcome to the podium to guest conduct our campus community band on Die Winter Rose, if I can pronounce this correctly, Stab's Musikmeister, Michael Joner.
Rejoice, for the source of our joy is the birth of a child. The angel came to Mary with news of an unexpected gift, news of a child, news of the Savior of our world. The birth would take place in a manger, in poverty and homeliness, a birth that brought hope despite its outward conditions. Have we forgotten about this hope? Have we misdirected our attention to the world, to ours and others' pain, to fear, to confusion about right and wrong? Have we taken on the responsibility and the blessing of sharing this hope?
Thank you.
The conditions surrounding Mary and Joseph before the birth were not calm. They were filled with travel, lack of shelter, the unknown. Turmoil is alive in our world, fear, mental instability, lack of physical safety, religious persecution. But the true hope of Christmas, bringing Jesus into the world to provide an option of forever with our Savior. Forever with joy, forever on the streets of gold, forever with Him and everything we need. That is what we must center on. Find peace. Remember peace. Choose peace in this season, in a world that does not choose it for you. The baby has been born. It is now the shepherd's turn to go and find him. They were told to do the unordinary and seek out the newborn baby. How often in a busy season do we stop and listen? Do we seek out the moments that we might not understand? Do we pursue what God has for us and in return experience the greatest blessing of drawing closer in relationship with God? Christmas is about him, the hope he brought, the peace he continually provides, and the relationship he designed us for.
Thank you.
Christmas brings with it beautiful lights, carols of joy, and many temptations to be distracted with our world, to be stripped of the peace and joy that he has provided us. Let us remember whose child we are, whose life was given for us, and we can celebrate his birth. But in the life that we have been blessed with, we can focus, share, exude joy, peace, and hope as we keep our gaze on him in this season.
Thank you. Thank you.
thank you so, here we go. Can you hear it? There we go. Thank you so very much. You may or may not know, but this group is about to go out and represent Dordt University across our country in January. They are coming back and giving up a portion of their Christmas break. We will rehearse here on the 3rd, depart on the 4th, and head out to Chicago, Indiana, Illinois, and Michigan, and all parts in between. I can't wait to share this wonderful music and these wonderful students with all of those in those states. We will have about a 5-minute break now, and we'll be back with the Wind Symphony. Thank you. So now I get to introduce the second of our guest conductors this evening. It is such a joy to have this great friend, great Marine, great leader of Marines, and just all around great human being, and all on top of that, a great brother-in-law. Up next to guest conduct Jose Moncayo's Wapango is a gentleman that I have known for probably about 20 or 25 years as well. We first met when we were serving as sergeants together in Marine Band New Orleans in New Orleans, Louisiana. When I joined the unit, I was a young, newly promoted sergeant. I'd probably been wearing three stripes up for less than a year, and Raul was a very seasoned, great leader, and continued to be a great leader and a great mentor to those of us that looked up to him and other Marines that we were striving to be like. So many years later, I never dreamt it would happen, but I just happened to marry his wife's sister, and here we are, brother-in-laws. The great thing, he spent the last 30 years serving our country as not only a Marine musician, which is absolutely important, but also as a Marine security guard. He served 2 years at the Pentagon and numerous other duties throughout our world, serving Marines around the world. And I'm lucky enough to keep up with the Marine band field, and I know that here in just a few months when he retires, that he will be a huge loss. Although there were people, there'll be Marines come up to follow him, but I'm not sure that the shoes can ever be filled. So please welcome to the podium for Moncayo's Wapango, my brother-in-law, Master Gunnery Sergeant Raul Caldera.
Thank you.
So one final time, we welcome one of our guest conductors to the stage. I've already introduced Michael. There's a ton more that I could say about him, but I know that the Wind Symphony has truly enjoyed making music with both Michael and Raul. It has been an exciting time. One of the things that one of my professors taught me when I was in my master's degree is that that podium is meant to be shared. It's not mine. And I think it's very valuable for all of us as musicians to be able to see other perspectives, other interpretations, and other ways of making music. So it's always so exciting to welcome guest conductors to the podium with any of our ensembles. So this piece was something Michael and I have talked about for quite some time. It's called Evening Prayer and Pantomime. You may be familiar with the Grimm brothers. They wrote a series of fairy tales. One of them was Hansel and Gretel. Well, Engelbert Humperdinck took this fairy tale, and Humperdinck was a very, very deeply Christian man. And he wanted to infuse his Christianity and his belief, his faith, into the story of Hansel and Gretel, which is exactly what he did with his children's opera. This is from the second act, Evening Prayer and Pantomime, by Engelbert Humperdinck, guest conducted by Staub's Musikmeister, Michael Jung. Once again, thank you so much for joining us this evening. We hope you've enjoyed the music. We have one last piece for you. This is a brand new piece written just a few months ago. My wife and I got to visit California this past summer and visit with Raul and Nina out in San Diego. And with the impending retirement from the Marine Corps coming up, on the flight home, I remember us talking, and I asked my wife, I said, you know, I really want to do something special. So when I got home, I sat down in my office here, and this is what came out. Hopefully this depicts not only Raul's 30 years of just selfless service to our country and to our Marine Corps, but to all of those that will come after him and have come before him that have made the E9 rank, that ultimate rank of Master Gunnery Sergeant. Those are the people that are training our future Marines to be those leaders in the future. So please enjoy March the Master Guns. Thank you.